You've been outside.
We're honored to host Senator Johnny Isakson at the Daily Performing Arts Center. I want to thank, we have numerous of our veterans here, and we thank you gentlemen and ladies, and we greatly appreciate all you come. I also want to thank Commissioner Mike Roby of the Georgia Department of Veteran Services and several of the senior staff who are with us tonight. So thank you, Commissioner. Senator Isakson is the only Georgian ever to have been elected to our state house, our state senate, the U.S. House, and the U.S. Senate, not to mention serving as chair of the State Board of Education. Johnny is the only senator who chairs two committees, the Senate Ethics Committee and the Senate Veterans Affairs Committee. We are here to have a civil discussion, may we?
Yes.
Working closely with Ranking Member John Tester, major legislation has passed this year to improve health care benefits and support provided by the Veterans Administration to our veterans. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a warm welcome to Senator Johnny Isakson. Thank you.
Good evening, Senator Al Lippart, Stone Mountain, Georgia, Veterans of Foreign Wars Department of Georgia, and a member of the National Legislative Committee for our national organization. Senator, the VFW has long worked with you and your staff on the important issues affecting veterans and their families. The VFW would like to first thank you for your bipartisan leadership on recent victories to include expanding the GI Bill, modernizing VA's appeals process, authorizing 28 VA medical leases, including one in Pike County, and ensuring continued funding for the Choice Act. We hope you can continue the momentum to finally expand the VA caregiver program to veterans who served before September the 11th, 2001. What is the plan to finally accomplish this in this current Congress? Thank you, sir.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you for your service to the country and to all of you from the veterans organizations. Please stand up. And everybody who's a veteran, please really stand up. That great country we all love so much wouldn't be the country it is today without these men and women. We appreciate you very much. It was my honor to serve too as well, and I appreciate it. The answer on caregivers, right now caregivers' benefits to veterans' families end post-Vietnam. Vietnam conflict of the veterans now are in the most need of assistance. I'm in the most need of assistance too, and I apologize for my call. Can't do anything about it. I have committed next year, along with Patty Murray, a Democrat from Washington State, to introduce legislation that will take caregivers through the Vietnam era, so all veterans will now be eligible to those benefits, not just veterans from certain era conflicts, but not others. Nobody deserves it more than those families. And caregivers are those husbands and wives and loved ones who provide the assistance and the service to those soldiers desperately injured fighting on behalf of our country. It's a way to give them the benefits and the help and the support to keep those people's quality of life high, and to a maximum extent, minimize the hospitalization and institutionalization of people, and maximize people's ability to live at home with their families. And I commit to you, I will be a co-sponsor of what's introduced next year, and I'll work as hard as I can to get it done. One of, since you asked that question, there's one other Vietnam era question that's out there, and that's the Blue Water Navy. There has been a claim for some time, that those soldiers and sailors that served on ships that carried napalm deserved the pay save benefit of others affected by napalm in our military. The scientific evidence on napalm is not as conclusive in terms of aircraft and that exposure as the benefits that are currently available. But death is a pretty conclusive thing for me. They risked their life for me and for you. I think the evidence is clear enough that we ought to include the Blue Water Navy benefits on that exposure so those people have the opportunity to survive the terrible diseases that are byproducts of napalm and its exposure. And I'm going to work on that as well. A guy with a yellow tie right over your shoulder, sir, there's somebody behind you. I'm going to get you both next. You first with the flag. No, sir, you.
Hang on.
That's okay. First, I wanted to thank you for your service to this country.
Still with the yellow tie.
Senator, my name is Justin. I'm from Rome, Georgia. I'm a student here at KSU, and I'm also a veteran. And before I ask anything, I just want to thank you on behalf of other student veterans for everything you have done and continue to do for support for us.